full-time faculty member and program coordinator for the PTA program here at BCC. And I have the honor of helping to coordinate and MC, I guess, our PTA pinning for 2022. So this is our class of 2022. And tonight we're here to celebrate and also be thankful for all that has happened in the last 2 years. We want to celebrate these students and their ability to enter into this field, this profession that we love so much, in a field that focuses on helping, promoting the idea of independence and healthy lifestyles for people in our community. Pinning symbolizes the transition from student to clinician. And we're here tonight to recognize the hard work and commitment of these students. It's through their persistence, their focus, and their teamwork that they are entering into a profession that will help people to reach their potential and strive for independence. Before we hear from our speakers, I want to take a moment to thank all the people who've helped to bring us to this evening. It takes a community to grow a PTA. I want to thank BCC's media, public relations, maintenance, the security department for preparing for tonight's event. They had to put up with me nagging at them, you know, where the chair is going to be set up, was the microphone going to be here, all of the things that happen, and they just kind of put up with it and are always behind the scenes doing the work. So I want to thank them. I also want to thank PCTV for streaming this event for our friends and family who can't be with us here today. And finally, I want to thank the family, friends, and the college community that supported our students along the way. At orientation, I let the students know that I think BCC probably has the strongest group of resources available to students at a college. If students need help with tutoring or advising or counseling, if they forgot their lunch, there is somebody to help them along the way. And those resources are just amazing, and believe it or not, they're all free. And the students that are sitting here, most of them took advantage of at least one of those type of resources. We also are lucky enough to work in collaboration with a group called AHEC. And AHEC stands for Area Health Education Center, and we work with them to provide education outside of our general curriculum to make them better clinicians. And you'll see in your program that a number of our students are identified as health scholars. These are students who did an additional 40 hours of work learning about ways to help keep our community healthy and strong. So I applaud them for that work, and I thank AHEC for all that they do. I also want to make sure that we thank family and friends. I look at all of you and I know that you're as tired as they are. You have cooked for them, you have cleaned for them, I bet. You have made sure that there was a car available when it needed to be used. You were the shoulder that maybe got leaned on and sometimes cried on. But you were also there when something really great happened. And it's because of you and all of the other support systems that they're sitting here today. So I want to thank all of you for that important work. And finally, I need to thank the other members of the PTA program. I'm standing here talking, but there are many people who are behind the scenes also assisting. Judy Guerin, who is full-time faculty in the PTA program and also coordinates all of the clinical sites. Without her, these students really wouldn't know how to work with real patients, so we thank her. I also want to thank Brittany Short, Jenny Valenti, you want to wave over there? Lily Lobovitz, and we are missing, I'm looking in the middle and that's not who I thought it was, it put me off guard. and Nina Newlands, who I don't see here yet, she's still in clinic. All of these people work as faculty members, they work as advisors, mentors, they assist the students with tutoring. They're an amazing group of people who are just always there for our students, so I want to thank them as well. So let's begin the celebration. We are lucky enough to have President Ellen Kennedy here with us tonight, and she's going to say a few words to all of you and the students. Thank you, Ellen.
congratulations to our physical therapist assistants who will be pinned tonight, who will graduate on June 3rd, and who will ace their national exam. I'm channeling that. I know how well prepared you are because I know your faculty, Michelle, Judy, the individuals you were just introduced to, who have supported you during this academic and clinical journey. And I know you have worked very hard to make this moment happen. My remarks will be brief, but I must mention that you may have noticed the campus was looking a bit ragged, a bit scraggly. We are participating in No Mow May to help the pollinators, and we struggled with the campus not being at its very best for special moments such as this. At our core, we have embraced sustainability and believed that our commitment to this philosophy must be practiced every chance we get. We are doing our part for Berkshire County and the bees, and now you can say you participated in No Mow May too. We have been hearing a lot about persistence and resilience. I won't belabor the point, but you each personify them, persistence and resilience. You've taken this journey during what we hope is a once-in-a-lifetime occurrence. You kept your focus on your goals and you completed your degrees. You were here when others were not, navigating a world that was unfamiliar, but recognizing that these challenges prepared you to help others with challenges that they face. In the course of your professional life, you will have patients for whom a single step is a miracle, and others who will, with your guidance, exceed their prior abilities and stamina because their own brush with mortality, illness, or strife caused them to reassess what was important. You will often help people gain self-confidence and goal clarity. The college's motto is, to travel hopefully is a better thing than to arrive. We have wrestled with the concept that this conveys. Shouldn't we all want to arrive? The full quote from Robert Louis Stevenson is, little do ye know your own blessedness, for to travel hopefully is a better thing than to arrive, and the true success is to labor. Your own labors, your journey will continue. You have, we hope, been instilled, if you didn't arrive with it, with a pursuit of lifelong learning and a recognition that you've chosen a profession that will continue to evolve and will be playing a growing and critical role in healthcare and healthy living. I love that Michelle referenced that earlier. You will always be traveling, learning, testing, discarding, and embracing. Thank you for making Berkshire Community College part of your journey. Be our ambassadors, proudly sharing where you made the transformation into a PTA, a physical therapy assistant, and mentor others to consider this field and this program. Congratulations to you, your family, friends, classmates, and to the wonderful faculty and support team who've supported you. We are all so proud of you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Ellen. I almost feel like we planned these conversations. It was perfect. I'm sorry to say that Dr. Kirsten Hunter isn't going to be able to speak tonight. I'm sure she has great words of wisdom that she would share with all of you, but she did send her good luck. So I'm going to go ahead and move on and introduce our keynote for the evening. It just speeds up the process. We get to celebrate sooner. This is a person that I've known for a very long time, and she is well known to BCC. Her name is Dr. Short. I knew her as Brittany Del Grande. She graduated from BC in 2013, and she truly epitomizes the idea of lifelong learning. Brittany graduated from BCC in 2013, and by 2017, she received her doctorate in physical therapy from Sage College. After she finished that wasn't enough. She went back and she got credentialed in lymphatics, which is a way to care for people who have problems with lymph drainage in their body. You might see extremities that are really swollen. And she took that upon herself to do as something additional. But she didn't stop there. So then she decided that she was going to become a certified specialist in orthopedics through the APTA, which is also a hard and grueling kind of process. Lots of people start it and don't stop it. She's certified now as an orthopedic specialist. Now, if you think all Brittany does is study, that's where you're wrong. She also works in clinic, and she is raising a 5-month-old son with her husband. And on top of that, she somehow finds time to teach both at Sage College in the doctorate program, and we're lucky enough to have her as a guest lecturer at BCC. So it's with great honor and privilege and proudness that I introduce Dr. Brittany Short.
Well, thank you, Michelle, and thank you, Judy. I wanted to start with that, and after that introduction, I can be a little more nervous. But I have a lot of respect for this program, and when Michelle and Judy asked me to speak, I really thought about what I wanted to talk about, and I want to speak to everyone, but especially to you. So I kept going back to the same thing, and I was recently talking to the CEO of our hospital before she retired, and I said, "Hey Diane, how'd you get to where you are today?" Because that's very intriguing to me. And she said, "You know, if somebody had told me I was going to be the CEO of a hospital when I was a little kid, I would have told them they were crazy." But the rest of her answer was really simple, and she said, "I was just that yes person. I was always somebody who said yes. If a patient needed to go to the bathroom, yep, I got it. If they were somebody who needed their sheets changed, I got it." And she was that person. So as I think of where I got to today, I think it's very similar. And before I started this program at BCC in 2011, I got a call a couple of days before the program started because I was on the wait list. And they said, "Hey, there's a spot, do you want it?" And I said, "Yes, sign me up." So at that point, I left a 4-year college. I had no idea what I wanted to do with my life. I moved back in with my parents, and here I was at BCC thinking, what did I just do? Like, this is not good. But little did I know, that was the first step in the direction of where I am now. So I want you guys to take a minute and look around at each other and appreciate and be proud of what you've accomplished over the last 2 years, because it is no easy feat. I wanted to tell a couple of stories tonight, and I kept going back to 3 of the same patients. So I'm going to share those stories with you, and I'm going to try to be somewhat quick. But one of my first patients as a PTA was this woman. She was short, statured, buzzed hair, and if I saw her on the sidewalk, I probably would have put my head down and just walked by. And I hated seeing her name on my schedule. She had a knee replacement, and she hated pain more than anyone that I know. And for all of these students, they've learned that that's a very painful surgery. And she wanted nothing to do with me. So one day, she needed a manipulation, which meant we both had to come in on a Saturday. And she looked at me and she said, "This is the last thing I want to be doing." And I said, "And you think this is how I want to spend my Saturday night as a 22-year-old who had better things to do in my mind?" And at that point, something changed. We both agreed on something, that we wanted to get what we had to get done and get out of there. And a year later, she graduated from physical therapy, but she kept coming to our office because we created a friendship and we were an outlet. This woman ended up passing away, and when I think about her and all of the moments we shared, this is the first lesson that I really learned, is that I never knew my opinion of somebody could change so much from the day I met them to the day they left my life. So let your patients surprise you. The second patient is another difficult one, so you see a theme here. And she was my first patient as a PT. She was very difficult, unhealthy, had sores, and her goal was to walk again. And so being a new PT, she came in and we walked and we had a great session, and she was motivated and I was motivated, and here we are thinking we can change the world. And about 2 days later, she comes back and starts screaming at me in the waiting room in front of everyone. So we go back and we talk, and she thought I hurt her, that we did way too much. And once we got past this, I put a gait belt on, she agreed to continue, and I walked to the other side of her, and she was covered in bruises and scrapes. And I said, "What happened?" And she said, "Oh, well, this weekend I was in my wheelchair and I had to go up a ramp, and so I went as fast as I could, I flipped my wheelchair right off the curb." And I said, and you don't think that that might have been what caused this? So like I said with lesson one, people are always going to surprise you. But secondly, sometimes you need to be their punching bag. So that's okay. Be the person that they need you to be on that day. And then the next day you can try again. That's the beauty of this field, is that we don't just work with somebody once. We see them again and again and again. So you have the opportunity to change their story. The last patient is somebody who was probably the hardest of all. And this person had seen 6 therapists before he worked his way to me. And all of them really passed him on because they were done working with him. They just needed a break. He'd been seen for over 100 visits, and I saw him for another 50. So we're talking 150 visits over the course of less than a year. And one of the problems was that he had a lawsuit with the hospital. And I knew I couldn't keep treating him because we weren't making any progress. This was the hardest lesson because it put my integrity at risk. And I had to discharge him. And so the third lesson here, although it's a shorter story without getting into all the details, is that sometimes in these situations we need to remember to stay ethical and do what is right. So don't forget that. As you all sit here and think about tonight and all you've accomplished over the last 2 years, I want you to remember that even though I wish I could say all the patients are wonderful, they won't always be. But I could have told stories about the patients I loved and the inspiring ones. And those aren't the ones who are going to teach you the most important lessons. They're just the ones who are going to keep you coming back. So when you have these difficult situations, reach out to each other. Reach out to Michelle or Judy, to me or Jenny or Lily or Nina or whoever you need to help you get through it. Because in the moment, we don't always see what we're learning, but when we look back, those are the ones that are going to help shape your career. So lastly, all of you said yes to sitting here and being a part of this program 2 years ago. For some of you, that may have started long before the 2 years of this program. And what I want you to take away tonight is to remember to be patient, remember to always do what's right, and always let your patients surprise you. Congratulations and welcome to the field of physical therapy.
Awesome job. So now, the reason that we're all here. Pinning is a time-honored ceremony that we use to recognize the progression of a student to a clinician. It's how we celebrate in many healthcare fields. So you'll see that our respiratory program has pinning, our nursing program has pinning, and lots of other healthcare programs across the country will do the same. And this dates back to medieval times, and being able to demonstrate that a certain level of skill and accomplishment has occurred. We as professionals take this ceremony incredibly seriously. We hold this ceremony close to us because it's a way for us to invite these new students into our profession. And when we invite them into our profession, we're saying that not only do they have the technical skills, but they have the ethics. They have those core soft skills, some people call them, that are so, so important. And again, I can't believe this is all tying together like we planned it. But that's kind of what Brittany's talking about, right? Is to be able to demonstrate that you have the patience, that you know what integrity is and you follow those things. And that's super important. That's part of why pinning is so important to us. We're going to say an oath at the end of our pinning, and you'll see that it really talks about what those values are that we hold so dear. So let's get started. So what I'm going to ask, if there are any therapists in the room, PTs or PTAs, I'd like you to come and stand right here. Judy's going to stand here. And what we'll do is, once we've pinned, we'd like the students to be congratulated by all of those that are in the profession. Perfect. So just so everyone can follow along, because I bet you there's some of you who would like to take pictures of your student, soon-to-be therapist, is we will, Judy and I will take turns talking about the student, and the other person will pin. We'll kind of hold that picture for a minute so you can take a picture if anyone wants to come up. And then the students will go back and stand by their seat till everyone has been pinned. We all got it? Okay. I think we can do this. All right. So let's go ahead and start.
So Nicole Bliss.
Woo-hoo!
Words that come to mind with Nikki are empathy and advocacy for patients. Thank you so much for sharing your experience with yoga, especially in our therapeutic exercise class and with your fellow clinicians during your clinical rotation. For Zooming and using OWL for recording during lab so that classmates participating virtually would feel included in your lab group. Your clinical instructor from this final rotation stated that they are not easily impressed, but they were impressed by you. Keep impressing yourself. And Christina Chilson, Chrissy. Organization, curiosity, and compassion come to mind. Creating too much organization could easily become an overwhelming task in this program, but you've learned to not to sweat the small stuff and have developed the confidence to apply what you do know and to ask those questions.
Megan was always looking out for everybody in class. She was always there to help when someone was struggling. And she just was on top of her game all the time. She just kept us right on our toes. And I appreciate all she's done. Owen. Owen is a quiet force. He's methodical and he's persistent. He works hard and doesn't give up. And it's these attributes that will help him to excel in physical therapy. Austin. Austin's fun and he's easy to get along with. His flexibility and his need to learn are probably the primary characteristics that he presents in any classroom setting. The therapists in Pennsylvania are going to be wowed by his caring and optimistic presence. Joe is deeply empathetic and understanding of others. He blends this with a strong need to understand theory and skill. He'll be a positive force in any clinic. can stand up. And we can go on and on with the positive attributes of these students. Truly, they have demonstrated such good skill and integrity and caring. But I don't want you to forget that this is a tough program. And they were also able to make sure that they knew all their material, they were safe with their patients, and they provided effective treatments. These are students who are smart and that are driven, and their personalities will help to motivate others to reach for that independence and healthier lifestyle that we really aspire to. So I want to remind my new colleagues, that's who you guys are now, that pinning not only symbolizes the entrance into our profession, but also the acceptance of our professional values. Each of you have demonstrated your diligence in attaining the values of altruism, caring, compassion, continued competency, duty, integrity, collaboration, and social responsibility. If you didn't know, those are the values of our profession. So I now ask all of the therapists in the room to read along with me and recite the PT oath, which is on this inside page. And I'm definitely going to need my glasses for this. Are you ready? As a physical therapist dedicated to providing the highest quality of care and service, I solemnly pledge I will respect the rights and dignity of all individuals who seek my services or with whom I work, act in a compassionate and trustworthy manner in all aspects of my services, exercise sound judgment while abiding by legal and ethical requirements, demonstrate integrity in interactions with colleagues, other healthcare providers, faculty, researchers, public, and payers for the enhancement of patient care and the advancement of the profession. Enhance my practice through lifelong acquisition and application of knowledge, skills, and professional behavior, and participate in efforts to make physical therapy and healthcare needs global, national, and global communities. Thus, with this oath, I accept the duties and responsibilities of the high physical therapy profession. Congratulations. Congratulations to the class of 2022. We, the faculty, are proud to call you our colleagues. Now, I say this all the time to you, so this isn't going to be a new line, but this is the last time I get to talk to you. I think I've said that a couple times already, right? But it was like in the lab before, so this is the last time here that I get to talk to you. That I have you captive and that you can't, like, leave. So I'm going to take advantage of it. You did it. I think that... remember the t-shirt that says, just do it? Like, you all should have t-shirts that said, I did it. Because I know that there are times that you thought you couldn't do it. And as you reflect on these last 2 years, and I hope that in the next couple of weeks you have an opportunity to do that, some quiet time, I want you to think about how you did it. My guess is that you did it through hard work and tenacity and a whole lot of help. Now, for some of you in the audience, you may think that help sounds like a weakness, and I would totally disagree with that. I think help is what makes us stronger. You all have received all sorts of help in the last 2 years. As I said earlier, some of it was maybe through what the college offered, through services or through a scholarship or you know, just having someone to talk to. But you've also had your family and your friends for support, and you've had each other. And that's what allowed you to do it. I'm sure that some of you in the audience figured that we all wore horns. We really made them work hard. Our expectations were really high, but they did it, and we knew that they could do it. So my last word of advice to you is never stop asking for help or providing help when someone asks a bit of you. It's through these interactions that we become stronger, smarter, and better. When we help each other, we're working as a team. And we have more wisdom, we have more skill, and we have more understanding. Know that BCC and the PTA faculty will always be part of your team. I hope that when you need help, you ask us. But I also hope, here we go, Jimmy, that when we need help, like taking a student, you'll help us. So, as I said, tonight is to celebrate the culmination of all your hard work, but it's also a time to say goodbye. I hope that you know that we here at BCC will always be here for you. Please stay in touch, send emails, call me, stop by, because we love to see you, we love to know what's going on in your lives, and it makes our day. It reminds us of what we can do, because while you're struggling, when you were struggling as students, it was a struggle for us too. We wanted to see you survive, so we're glad that you're here. Thanks for choosing BCC and trusting in us and letting us help share your success. So to close this celebration, one of our students, Owen, is going to say a few words and then they have a PowerPoint presentation. Good luck to you all.
Hello and thank you to everyone that is joining us this evening to help celebrate our completion of the PTA program. And yes, just forewarning, I did print my speech out because I feel that I've memorized plenty of things in the past 2 years, so I feel like I can sit this one out. It truly is hard to believe that we are here at the pinning ceremony already. 2 years ago, this was not even a thought in our minds yet, but here we are. It is also crazy that I'm saying 2 years ago. Well, certainly, at times, it feels like it was never ending and truly went by in a blink. I guess that's why they say time flies when you're having fun. I would like to start off with thanking my friends and family members, as well as all of my classmates, friends, and family. Thank you for putting up with us being gone at school for long hours and for our little to no time that we worked our current jobs, and for helping us study and supporting us through the journey of becoming PTAs. So if we could please have a hand for the friends and family of my peers. Find where I left off, there we go. Next, I'd like to thank everyone that helped educate us through the course and everyone that helped us along. Colleen and Anthony were amazing, whether they were doing paperwork for us, helping us set up the lab, or most importantly, ordering us pizza on occasions. Our journey through the program would not have been as smooth without their assistance. I'd also like to put out my thanks to all of the clinical instructors throughout our clinical rotations that helped us applying our schooling into the real world and also teaching us a new trick or two. Most importantly, I would like to thank our professors and who have taught us the most of what we know and have helped shape us into PTAs. Michelle, Judy, Nina, and all our guest lecturers all did an amazing job of passing on their knowledge and experience to help us become the best therapists that we can. Also, thank you for putting up with our group. I feel that we could be a rowdy and very joking group on occasions, but I guess we couldn't have been too bad seeing how you still came to class every day. We truly appreciate all that you've done for us, and to show our gratitude, we have a gift for you from the class of 2022. During the neuro unit, we always talked about double therapy ball, or as we like to call it, the peanut, but we never actually had one to use in the lab. Well, now you do have, and hopefully they'll be able to use and help future students, but also save you the time of trying to scribe and look up a picture of what it looks like for students. So if we could please have a round of applause for the teachers and all those helpers. I would also like to thank all of my peers. I would not have enjoyed this program as much as I did without each and every one of you. As a group, we had an amazing characteristic, and that was our support for one another. We always had each other's backs and would help one another whenever needed. Whether it was school-related or personal, we were always there. I really don't feel that addressing us as a group would be good enough, so I'd like to take a few sentences to describe each one of my classmates for you. And this isn't a randomized order, so don't think if you're first or last. I will have each one of you give a little wave as well, just so we know who we're talking about when I say your name. Chrissy is known as for us as the mom of the group, because she was always looking out for each and every one of us. She's also one of the most caring people that I know and always concerned for people's safety and well-being. Kat always seems to have the great idea of the group, whether it be getting a coffee maker for the classroom or getting the group together to participate in the Berks Fitness Challenge. She's always come up with wonderful ideas. Nikki is one of the toughest people I have met, and she has truly inspired me throughout the tough of a person she is. With whatever crazy things were happening in her life or at school, she would always be there every day giving 110% effort. She is also very good at being a difficult patient during life. Austin has been an amazing driving buddy and friend. It was always great to have him on our hour ride down here to school, whether we'd be jamming up to music or talking about whatever. Whenever we had to ride down separately, I really would feel lonely and miss his company. Maddie. I know Maddie was unable to make it here tonight, but I'd also like to talk about her. We didn't have as much time with Maddie, seeing how she joined us with our last semester, but she was always very kind to all of us in the class, and I feel she did a wonderful job being thrown into a class with a whole bunch of random people, especially a group like us. Joe overall was the guy to talk, if you ask me. He would always be willing to talk about anything with you. I love to just sit around and talk to Joe on breaks after between classes. And one thing I like about Joe, he'd tell you how things are. Never sugarcoated anything, and just tell you how it is. Which I really think is great, and is very needed throughout the program. Megan. I feel that she may be a little mad at me for saying this, but Megan is very smart. If you had a question about anything that we're doing in class, you would go to Megan, and almost always, she would have the answer for you. So thank you, Megan, for putting up with our millions of questions. And that makes up the class of 2022. They're all amazing in their own way that really helped us get through the course and become such a close group. I'd like to take back what I said earlier as well. These people are not my peers. Peers is not a strong enough word to describe what they are to me. This is my PTA family, and always will be. We will all move on to find jobs somewhere and get to have another group of PTAs or PTs to call our physical therapy family, but you guys will be my first and true PT family. I thank each and every one of you for being the amazing person that you are and helping me through this program and on our journey to becoming PTAs. While there is a chance that we may part today and never see each other again in our lives, I'm sure we will stay in touch as we move on to the next chapters of our lives. I can proudly and confidently say that I know that this group of PTAs in front of you will make an amazing group of therapists and change people's lives for the better. Thank you. And now we'll play our slideshow together, Megan, you put it together, correct? Or kind of in a group of all our pictures for the year, and there is going to be a song playing, and the song, Don't Be Alarmed, is just a song we use to help memorize our cranial nerves. Such heaven, such
but there was one thank you that I forgot. And Owen brought it up, and I need to say something. And this is Anthony Montalione, who's sitting here in the corner. Anthony is our lab tech extraordinaire. We have him for 18 hours a week, and he does about 40 hours of work. So, and he is the one that keeps us organized and sane, as Owen kind of talked about. So this pinning ceremony, I'm sorry, I keep hitting your mic. This pinning ceremony would not have gone off as smoothly as it had if it wasn't for Anthony. So I have to thank him for that. So that's the end of our ceremony. I hope you'll come and have some cupcakes and some water with us. You'll see there are signs with gluten-free cupcakes. And then there are regular, they're filled with raspberry. We had them last year. They're absolutely delicious. So, and they're all in like little containers, so you can take one home if you don't want to eat it now. Have a great night.